This video is going to be about finding the slopes of horizontal and vertical lines. So let's get started. Here's a graph with a horizontal line. And it looks like it goes through the point, let's see, this looks like a 3. So that would be the point 0, 3. And we have to find the slope for it. So let's use the equation for slope. Remember, the equation for slope is m stands for slope, equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So we need two points. We've got a point here already. That's the 0, 3. And we'll take this point. This point looks like it's at 4. So this would be 4, 3. And we could call this x sub 1 and y sub 1, x sub 2 and y sub 2. And we'll use this equation to figure out the slope. So m equals, let's see, y sub 2 is 3 minus y sub 1 is 3. And then x sub 2 is 4 minus x sub 1 is 0. So 3 minus 3 is 0, and 4 minus 0 is 4. Well, if I have a fraction, anytime the numerator is 0, that means the fraction equals 0. So that means the slope is 0. And I guess this makes sense. Let's look at this line. You know, if I had a positive slope would be a line that goes up like that. So all of these would be positive slopes. If I had a negative slope, it would be a line that goes down. So in between all these lines that go down and all these lines that go up is this line here that doesn't go up or down. So in between positive numbers and negative numbers is going to be just 0. So my slope is 0. And another way to think about this would be we could write the equation for this line. So let's try y equals mx plus b. My slope is 0, so y equals, remember m is slope, equals 0x plus, and b will be 3 plus 3. But I don't have to write 0x, it doesn't do anything. So this equation is just going to be y equals 3. And that makes sense because looking at this line, everywhere on this line, the y equals 3. Okay, so if you have a horizontal line, the things to remember, the slope of a horizontal line is 0. The equation for the horizontal line will be y equals, and then what number that y always is. And you can just look at the y-intercept to find out what that number is. In this case, it's the 3. Okay, let's go on to vertical lines. So here I've got a vertical line. Looks like it goes through the point negative 2. So that's going to be negative 2 and 0. And we'll do the same thing. So we want to find the slope. The slope is y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. I can call this x sub 1 and y sub 1. I'll take another point like here. And that looks like it's at the 3. So this point would be, I'm still at negative 2, negative 2, 3. And we'll call this x sub 2 and y sub 2. So let's plug these numbers into my equation for the slope. So the slope is going to equal y sub 2 is 3, y sub 1 is 0, so 3 minus 0 over negative 2 minus negative 2 again. Okay, so if we work this out, we're going to get the slope equals 3 minus 0 is 3. Negative 2 minus negative 2. Well, two negatives are a positive. So negative 2 plus 2 will just be 0. But you remember, I can't divide by 0. This number in math, any fraction with 0 in the denominator, is undefined. So that means my slope for a vertical line is going to be undefined. There's no definition for it. And we can think of this in terms of an equation if we want to. In this case, the x is always negative 2. So the equation for a vertical line is going to start with x equals, and then whatever number the x, this line, always is. And this line is always at negative 2 all the way along here. So I'll have x equals negative 2. Okay, so just to review this one more time. When you have a horizontal line, the slope will always be 0, and the equation will be y equals whatever number the line, whatever y value the line always is. For a vertical line, the slope will always be undefined, and the equation is going to be x equals, and then whatever x value this line always is. So make sure you understand these. They occur very often on tests. Take care. I'll see you next time.